بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Eating out in a restaurant is a common practice by many people around the world today, and it's usually something people look forward to. As believers, in order for the outing to be blessed and indeed acceptable, it must conform to Islamic guidelines and principles. Now, here are four things you should know about eating in a restaurant. Number one, if you're planning to eat meat, then the meat needs to be slaughtered according to Sharia, i.e. known as dhabiha or halal meat. How do you know if a restaurant serves halal meat? Is a sign enough? Here's how. If the owner or the person responsible for the restaurant is Muslim, and there is no valid or authenticated reason for you to doubt them, and they say the meat is halal, then you can consume the meat. If the owner is non-Muslim though, you can't just take their word for it and must investigate. Now, we need to ask where the meat is purchased from and attain satisfaction that it was obtained from a Muslim and that it's halal. The thing here is personal satisfaction, itmi'inan. Please note, therefore, that whilst you may be satisfied, others may not be. And so, we should not judge people or spread unsubstantiated rumors about certain restaurants. Now, what if the restaurant that serves halal meat and whose owner is Muslim also serves alcohol? Yes, it is permissible and it's halal to eat there, provided we have likelihood that the meat is halal. If it's a non-halal meat restaurant which serves vegetarian food, which does not have forbidden ingredients or drinks such as alcohol, there is no problem in having that vegetarian meal in that restaurant. If it's a restaurant that has halal meat and non-halal meat, we must ensure that the halal meat is cooked separately and not contaminated, since non-halal meat is najis, impure. 2. Having fish. It is vital and necessary that we ascertain, establish the type of fish we are consuming to have scales. Just assuming or hoping it has scales is not good enough. We need to ask for the name of the fish and search online, for example, whether it has scales or not. If it doesn't, it's not permissible to eat it. For example, during a flight mid-air, if one of the meal options given by the airline is fish, we must establish the type of fish before eating. If we can't find out which category it is from, i.e. is it from the fish with scales or not, we are not allowed to eat it. Scholars are quite strict on the fish and the necessity of scales. Eating shrimp is allowed, but eating lobster is haram according to many jurists, including Ayatollah Sistani. It is also forbidden to eat frogs, turtles, every amphibious animal, snails, and crayfish. 3. Sometimes people go out to restaurants with friends who are non-Muslim. They may find themselves sitting in the same table where alcohol is consumed. It is not permissible to eat or drink at the same table where alcohol is being consumed. Based on obligatory precaution, sitting in such a table without eating or drinking is not allowed too. But if there are two tables next to each other and you're sitting in the one where no one is having alcohol, that is fine. Now, for some people, this may be problematic and they might feel embarrassed to express their beliefs before non-Muslims. Remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching us, and people should be respected for their faith, even if others don't understand the reasons behind it. For example, in mid-air, whilst we're in a plane sometimes, we are told not to eat nuts if we're sitting next to or close to someone with an allergy for nuts. And people respect that. Similarly, we must have submission and reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and choose that which pleases Him, and not necessarily the people. 4. We are not required to inquire about the religion or faith of the chef or the person cooking the food in a restaurant. Even if for some reason we found out that the chef or others preparing the food are not from the Ahlul Kitab, e.g. for example from the Hindu faith, we can still eat the food, since we would not know whether they touched the food with their wet hands directly. We don't need to ask if they actually touch the food with their wet hands either.